One of these young men holds an unusual world record. What is your name, please?
My name is Randy Gardner.
My name is Randy Gardner.
My name is Randy Gardner.
Only one of these young men is the real Randy Gardner. The other two are imposters, and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, Peggy Cass, Orson Bean, and Kitty Carlisle. On to Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collyer.
Thank you very much, and welcome once again to Tell the Truth, brought to you this week by Anacin, the headache tablet to relieve pain, to relax tension, to calm nerves. Anacin. Good evening, panel.
Good evening.
How are you this evening?
Giddy tonight. Giddy.
All right, you can open up the envelope, if you will, please, and follow along with me. I, Randy Gardner, am a high school senior. For a science fair at my school, two friends and I conducted a controlled experiment to see how long I could stay awake. Throughout the experiment, my friends kept an accurate record of my physical and psychological reactions. A medical doctor supervised the project, and during the last stages, a well-known psychologist and sleep specialist recorded my brain waves. Using no artificial stimulants whatsoever, I established a new world's record by staying awake for 264 hours, 11 days and nights with absolutely no sleep. Signed, Randy Gardner. These three young men all claim to be Randy Gardner, who stayed awake for 11 days and 11 nights. And we start this questioning with Orson Bean. Orson?
Yes, thank you. But Mr. Gardner, number one, have you ever eaten a goldfish? There used to be a craze in goldfish eating. You were never part of that sort of thing, were you?
No, sir, I never ate
a goldfish. Or cramming into phone booths or anything like that?
Never.
This was a scientific experiment, in other words.
It was not a gag.
Number three, why did you do it?
Well, there was a science fair in my high school, and we were doing it for the fair.
And what did you find out from it, number three?
Well, we just helped to reprove a few facts. One, that you didn't have to make up all the sleep that you had missed. You only had to sleep a short time, and you could make it all up in that amount of time.
Number two, how long did you sleep the minute you were through with the 11 days and nights?
14 hours and 43 minutes.
And did you feel lousy when you woke up, or was it great?
Well, not great, but it was okay.
Kitty Carlisle.
Number one, did you have a loss of memory during this time?
Towards the end, we recorded some irritability and a loss of memory.
Number two, what did you eat during this time? Did you have a special diet?
No, ma'am, no special diet, just what I would usually eat.
Number three, where did you go to do this experiment? Did you stay in one place? Did you move about?
Well, we did it mostly in my room, in my house, but I also was allowed outside during the day to walk around.
Number one, what kept you awake?
I took many showers.
I did.
Number three, two, you didn't have to be walked around? Oh, dear.
Tom Poston.
Where are you from, number one?
I'm from Roswell, New Mexico.
Number two, where are you from, please?
San Diego.
Where are you from, number three?
Teaneck, New Jersey.
Number two, what mental stimulants did you use? What did you find was the most effective means of staying awake?
Just actually talking yourself into it is about the best one I can think of.
Number three, what did you find was the most effective in keeping you awake, mental stimulation that you used?
Well, usually talking to the friends that were in the room with me.
I see. Number one, did you do any exercise?
Yes, I did.
Number two, did you do any special exercises to keep the brain awake?
Nothing special, no.
How did you...
Peggy Cass.
Number two, how did you pass the time when the other people were sleeping? I mean, like when your family went to bed at night, what did you do?
Well, there was always someone with me, the two boys that helped me. One would sleep and one would stay awake with me.
Oh, they took shifts.
Yeah.
Number three, did your friend stay in your mother's house? I mean, while...
Oh, yes, they slept over.
She must have been charmed to have those two guests for 11 days and 11 nights. Number one, did you have loss of appetite?
Not a bit.
Not a bit. Now, when the other people were sleeping, did you find you made an extra meal, like you had four meals a day because you were up extra hours?
No, this was a controlled experiment, so I ate regularly, just three meals a day.
And then you wouldn't eat like...
And that's all the time we have. But all you bright-eyed people now, suppose you mark your ballots. Mark them at once, without change, and of course, without consultation, because now it is time to vote. Vote, if you will, for number one, number two, or number three. Our team of challengers will receive $250 for every incorrect vote. All ballots marked? Very well, Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number two because I don't remember any science fairs in Teaneck.
Peggy Cass, what is your choice?
I voted for number two because I figured if this had happened in Teaneck, I would have heard about it. But two's from San Diego, and I don't know what goes on in San Diego. So that's why I voted for two.
Orson Bean, which one do you think it is?
Yes, well, it's hard to picture anyone staying awake for days on end in New Jersey. But still, number one says that, number one said he took a lot of showers and he looks clean to me, so I voted for him.
Kitty Carlisle.
I voted for number two because he looks the sleepiest.
All right, it's not too widely spread. There are three for number two, one for number one. Let's go in with that, shall we, and find out how the charm circle of truth throws its light on it. As we learn now, which of these young men actually did set a record by staying awake 11 days and 11 nights? Will the real Randy Gardner please... I was going to say wake up. Stand up. Please stand up. Randy Gardner is a senior at Point Loma High School in San Diego, California. This is where he conducted his experiment. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Dave Woodruff, and I'm a professional folk singer.
And number three, what is your real name and what do you do, sir?
My name is Chuck Edwards, and I'm a professional magician.
Checking the score, we find there was only one incorrect vote, but that's worth $250 from Anison. And, of course, there will be a package of all of the fine products from the makers of Anison waiting for you. Along with that goes our sincere and warm thanks for helping us play our game tonight. And our only hope is that you look back upon it as a very fond memory. Goodbye, and God bless you.